Hey, all my movie maniacs out there, time once again, and we've got a doozy of a film for you today, and it's called Frankenstein's Army. Now, we're getting told the story of Frankenstein's Army. We're told the story near the end of World War II, and we've got Sergi, who was tasked with filming the activities of the group of soldiers he's with as they cross into Germany. And so, yes, this is a found footage film. He's filming with his film camera, a couple of them actually, as they trek across the German landscape. Well, then they happen across a secret lab where they're putting pieces of soldiers together to create new soldiers. We see the horrors unfold from there as these soldiers from Mother Russia decide to try to take care of this secret lab with these monstrosities against humanity. Wow. One thing you can say about Frankenstein's Army is that the production design in this film is unique. Now, maybe that's because the director of this film and the guy who came up with this film has been an art director in many films. So this is his first full-length feature, and I guess it's taken a while to get to the screen, you know, to distribution. And let me tell you, it's worth the wait. Some of these creations that they came up with in the Frankenstein's lab will blow your mind. Are things you haven't seen before. This is about as close. Let me get this. I used to play Wolfenstein 3D, and if anybody's played the other Wolfensteins as well, this is about as close as you're going to get to a Wolfenstein movie. In fact, I would love to see this as a video game with the creations he came up with. Just wild stuff you wouldn't think of. Stuff that just are outside the norm. They're not just humans with things attached to them. Trust me on this. There's plenty of gore effects in here as well, and some scary moments. Now, with it being a found footage film, it does kind of limit the way it's directed and what you see, but let me tell you, it does get you into the film by telling it from the first person perspective. But the only problem I really had with Frankenstein's Army was the fact, again, it was a found footage film. This is film in World War II, and it was rather crisp and clean for such a film to be. So, you know, that took me a little while to buy into, and that suspension of disbelief was just a little bit. But once I got over that, I really got into the film. What's also interesting is that at first glance, or when you first watch the film, you may think this is kind of a tongue-in-cheek poke fun at horror films, but it's not. Once we get to a scene where the Mother Russia soldiers get into a town, and things kind of take a dark turn with these soldiers, and then things just get darker and more crazy from there. Frankenstein's Army definitely is for the gore whores out there, definitely for those who like a different horror film and are really looking for something visually different. I don't remember being this visually stunned by a horror movie since I watched Nightbreed, okay? Kind of tells you exactly where we're going. Or House of a Thousand Corpses as well, the visuals near the end. Just some wild, crazy shit you wouldn't have thought of. That's what you get in Frankenstein's Army, and it is an entertaining time. It's not too long of a film, and it's on video on demand right now. I highly recommend it for those of you looking for a good horror film. Those gore whores out there, it's definitely for you. And if you're looking for an interesting, visually different horror film, check out Frankenstein's Army. And that'll about do it for us here at the Final Cut. Till next time, keep that ticket stub.